From the heart of the Cape, this is Barnstable Today for Thursday, October 23rd. Welcome aboard. I'm Mark Mumford.
Student debaters at Barnstable High School have their say on the presidential race. That's our top story. Thanks for joining us. I'm Kevin Friel.
A standing room only crowd packed the Knight Auditorium on the West Main Street campus yesterday to witness that give and take.
The student debate was moderated by retired BHS history teacher Len Gobeil, who now works out of the town manager's office.
We had a coin flip yesterday. As a result of the coin flip, the first question will be asked to the Republicans. They will have 3 minutes to answer the question, followed by a 1 minute rebuttal by the Democrats. The second question will obviously go to the Democrats. They'll have 3 minutes, and the Republicans will have 1 minute in a rebuttal. The first question will be, for the Republicans.
What are your plans for alternative energy, offshore drilling, and our dependence on foreign oil?
Also, if we drill in Anwar, it'll take about 10 years to get the oil out of the ground, which we should have started 10 years ago due to the oil crisis we have now. And we need to drill domestically, because if we keep relying on foreign oil, that's a problem because they control our oil sources. Oil is in not only our cars and our buses, it's in our homes, is our heat. If we go to war with Saudi Arabia, which is the big oil source of our country, then they can completely just cut off our oil supply. So if we drill domestically and have it on our own land, then we can be able to take it for ourselves and be a self-sufficient country when it comes to oil.
Okay, your time is up. Democrats, would you like to rebut?
All right, well, everything that they just told you is what the Republicans have been saying for a long time, is that we just need to drill, baby, drill, that's what their phrase is, and that we need to start drilling in Anwar, we need to use coal, and we just need to keep burning all these things that pollute the environment and aren't really solving the major problem. What we have to do is we can drill, we can use clean coal, as Barack Obama has supported, but we have to have a more comprehensive plan that uses alternative energy as well as drilling for oil domestically. If all we do is start drilling for oil, that will not solve our problem. The United States has 3% of the world's oil, but we use 25% of the world's oil. So how could we solve our problem with all these like dirty fuels that aren't really going to solve our energy crisis? We need to start. Barack Obama wants to invest about $150 billion in alternative energy over 10 years. And while not all the jobs will be created at the very start, We will create many more jobs in green energy with wind, solar, and even nuclear than we would just by drilling for oil in Alaska.
If you guys stand up for a moment, How about a nice round of applause for you? Putting this affair on this morning, and as I said earlier, it has been recorded and will be on channel 18. So turn on channel 18, you get a view of exactly what happened this morning, and you see it again. Thank you so much. And don't forget to vote.
Meanwhile, the impact from the Barnstable High School Drama Department's recent massive production of The Wizard of Oz continues to resonate.
The WB Network spent 350 hours recording the making of that student production. Those recordings have been encapsulated into a series of so-called webisodes that are now showing on the internet.
Barnstable High School drama guru John Sullivan detailed the positive feedback for the school committee.
I think on the whole, our kids handled it well. I think that the worst thing was is that they needed a schedule from me of all the rehearsals before I had even started auditions. So I didn't know anybody's work schedule. I didn't know anything. I just said, okay, Dorothy and the Lion are going to meet on this day. The Tin Man's meeting on this day. And they scheduled cameras to come down on those days because they had to pay cameramen to come down. So I was stuck in a schedule that I made in December to go through the whole thing. But we did it, and it worked out very well. Just to close, just before I got here, an email came in from the creator of the series. James Parsley. There were two men that were here. One was dark-haired, one was blonde. The dark-haired man was James Parsley, and he's the man who actually came up with the idea for the series and helped really sell the fact that they wanted to come here to Barnstable. And Mr. O'Toole, the assistant drama coach, has got that letter. And his glasses. No, not me.
Good evening. John is shy.
And a lousy name.
This says, Dear John, I wanted to say thanks for such an enjoyable and inspiring process in working with you, the Barnstable Drama Club, and Barnstable High itself. Warner Brothers is thrilled with the show, and as its creator and executive producer, I am delighted that the original vision was actualized. This doesn't happen every day. We were impressed with the level of professionalism of the students and by how much trust you put in them. However, I think we particularly appreciated how unimpressed the students and faculty were by having our cameras around. I can't tell you how many projects I've done over the years in which people's behavior was affected, often adversely, by the lure of the camera. Not so at Barnstable. The students and faculty took it in stride like some Northeaster they knew would eventually move on. I really don't recall a more grounded bunch than you all. I recall over half a year ago, your greatest concern and that of Pat and the school board was not to hurt anyone in the making of this documentary. I hope we honored that trust. We will keep you posted on the viewership of the series, but by all accounts, it was a big hit. Congrats to everyone. Sincerely, James Persolet, executive producer.
So again, if you haven't seen it, okay, thewb.com, and there we are. Now I'm yelling at small children until they cry, and Jason's running around yelling at me. So the funniest episode involves Jason when we go to see the horse, and I'm torn because the horse cost a lot, and I don't want to talk about cost right now. It cost a lot, and I was saying, but it's going to be something that everybody remembers. That's the thing people will be talking about. We'll bring more people in. We'll make money that way. And Jason shaking his head. He was a treasurer. He's shaking his head. No, 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 no. And so we're all talking about money all the time. And finally, it shows me sitting in the seat talking about. I said, we just need a little piece of pine about this big with some. And I was trying to explain some kind of unit. And he's staring at me, this dead stare. Like I'm going to spend another $1 million or something like that. And I just broke off and went, what? It's going to cost 16 cents. You know? So I really enjoy doing it. The kids were great doing it. They behaved themselves as I knew they would. Once again, I even expressed this today. We're not just a kind of a club. We're kind of a family. And they all stuck up for each other, and they all defended each other, and they all looked out for each other. And that's the way I like it, and that's the way it worked. Thank goodness. Okay.
It could be a good night for catching a webisode or two as we feature mostly clear skies, but it promises to be a bit on the chilly side tonight with lows slipping down to about 30. Then tomorrow, plenty of sunshine with a touch warmer with light winds out of the northwest and highs back near 60.
On the meeting front tonight, it's the second Charter Commission session in as many nights. This evening, starting at 7 in the Town Hall hearing room.
Some good news and some thanks out of the Town Clerk's office as Linda Hutchenrider says plenty of campaign workers have come forward and they're up to full strength in that regard.
Meanwhile, over at the Senior Center, they are still looking for some good drivers. They are seeking volunteers that can commit to 4 hours one day a week to drive the center's van. Contact Junie Red at the Senior Center if you are interested. Thanks for joining us today. I'm Kevin Friel.
We'll see you right back here tomorrow. I'm Mark Mumford.